it is a contribution to the development of knowledge about interrelationships between poverty and unmet need in reproductive health in Africa. The study will specifically look at the impact, the specific impact of the poverty in the occurrence of unmet need in reproductive health, also the role of unmet need in the emergence of permanence of or rising of poverty level within the among adolescents and youth. Compared to other regions, South Africa has the lowest modern contraceptive prevalence rates among married women, 6.6% in Central Africa, and the largest total fertility rate. This is about 6 children per woman. It has also the highest maternal mortality ratio. That is 1,000, more than 1,000 maternal death per 100,000 live birth. Also have the highest adolescent fertility rate. That is 138 per 1,000 live birth. And the lowest antenatal care coverage. This is about 15% of adolescent or youth have at least 4 visits are recommended by WHO. Otherwise, multiple partnerships is very common in Central Africa. It is among 41% of males in Cameroon, for example. Unprotected premarital sex is the norm, about 82% in Chad, 74% in Congo, and 36% in Cameroon. Also, we have a substantial proportion of young adults who have an incomplete knowledge of the 3 main ways to prevent HIV infection. We lack that data on abortion among youth, but it is a matter of concern. For example, in Gabon, it is 15% of adolescents or youth. Women who age between 20 to 24 who have report induced abortion. But according to the DHS data, reproductive health services are lagging behind in many areas to meet youth reproductive needs. Last estimate of unmet need for family planning among married women between 15 to 24 range from 17% in Central African Republic to 30% in Gabon. We have a sizable share of unmarried and sexually active women between 15 to 24 also have unmet need. It is 70% in Cameroon and 23% in Gabon. A minority of women aged between 15 to 24 recall having been told about pregnancy complications during antenatal visit. That is 16% in Chad and close to 40% in Congo. Moreover, the income poverty it is very high in the region. More than half of the population live with less than $2 per day. In most Central Africa country, the life expectancy show a downward trend reflecting an increase of the non-monetary poverty. Theoretically, the relationship between poverty and unmet need for family planning can be interpreted in 2 ways. First, poverty promotes the occurrence of unmet need for family planning. Adolescent or youth living in poverty often engage in risky sex of unwanted pregnancy as a survival strategy after some income shock, for example. The second, unwanted fertility may adversely affect the living condition of adolescents and youth by restricting their access to schooling and employment. Oh, let me say first that our research is based on DHS data and original data to be collected in Cameroon and in Congo, including biographical survey to analyze the determinant of outcome of reproductive health among youth and in a life scores approach, and qualitative survey also to better capture perception and belief related to reproductive health, and social situational surveys to focus on national reproductive program and policy in terms of level of implementation, in terms of attention paid to specific need of youth. So according to the DHS data, after controlling for all the explanatory variables available in the data, the likelihood of reporting unmet need for family planning among married women aged from 15 to 24 is higher in the poorest quintile of household wealth in Cameroon, Gabon, and Congo. In this country, the fertility, including the desired fertility, decline very low, still the decline very low, particularly among the poor. But in Chad, the reverse pattern is observed. In this country, the fertility transition has not started yet, even among the rich. But biographical, qualitative, and situational survey have been recently made in Cameroon, and analyses are still in progress. So the results are not yet available, but preliminary results indicate surprisingly that young boys rarely attend sexual and reproductive services. When they do so, it is usually for an STI, sexually transmitted infection, which are at an advanced stage. Also, we find that young people you express the need of friendly health service allocated to them, but most of the health service survey do not meet this need. So once we analyze all the data collected, the result of the research will contribute to translating the specific needs of adolescents and youth into policy and program population and poverty reduction. We expect the study to demonstrate that improving reproductive health of adolescents and youth is possible through better consideration of their needs, expectation and preference, and through a better education with better reproductive health also, and education, adolescents and youth people and young people will be able to contribute more to the reduction of the current demographic gap, which is the high fertility among the poor population, and to a demographic dividend for economic development and poverty reduction.